Welcome to MedSeekers. What can you expect in this video? In this video, I'll be talking in detail about JIPMA International School of Public Health Masters in Public Health program. Here I have outlined what I'll be talking in this video. If you are a student who is interested in Masters in Public Health program, do stick on to this video till the end. Before diving into today's video, if you are new to my channel, I welcome you to MedSeekers. I post all the educational content related to medicos, paramedics and public health professionals. Do consider subscribing to channel if it's helpful for you. If you are interested in today's video, do hit the like button. This is my Insta ID MedSeekers9. Coming to Masters in Public Health course at JIPMA. JIPMA has very good NIRF ranking and they have very good medical college ranking in India. It is a national institute which works autonomously under Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. They have tie up with Harvard School of Public Health. It is located in Pondicherry. Masters in Public Health course is a 2-year program. First year you will be having 2 semesters, second year you will be having 2 semesters. Before going to talk about eligibility criteria for Masters in Public Health program at JIPMA, there is one very important question to be answered. There are many inbox messages with the same question. Is 2 years of experience mandatory for JIPMA Masters in Public Health program? No, it's not mandatory. Even if you are a fresher, you have to just meet the specified eligibility criteria. You can download latest 2021 prospectus. They have clearly mentioned it's desirable, it's not mandatory. Coming to eligibility criteria for JIPMA Masters in Public Health program, this particular snap I have taken from latest 2021 prospectus. This is the eligibility criteria for non-sponsored category. Any applicant with qualification of MBBS, Dental, BE, BTech or BSc Nursing or Veterinary Sciences, Ayush, Allied Health or Social Sciences of any recognized university. You should have cleared your degree within the first attempt with minimum 50% of marks. 3 points you have to remember. You have to be the specified degree whatever I have mentioned here. And second thing is that you should have cleared your degree within the first attempt with minimum 50% of marks. See here they have clearly stated it's just desirable, it's not mandatory. Even without experience, if you are a fresher, if you meet the specified eligibility criteria, you can apply for JIPMA Masters in Public Health program. Medical, dental, veterinary, nursing, Ayush graduates should have registered with their respective state registration council. See, all the students keep one point in mind. Whenever during the counseling or admission process, you have to submit attempt certificate. Like within how many attempts you have cleared your degree. Make sure you meet the eligibility criteria before you apply for Masters in Public Health program at JIPMA. Regarding sponsored category Masters in Public Health program, we have discussed in many other videos, so I am not going in detail in this video. See, for JIPMA Masters in Public Health program, even sponsored candidates also should appear for entrance exam. You should score minimum 50% of marks. And one very important point is that sponsored seats will not be pooled in the general seats. Note this point. Later on, we'll talk in detail about this point in this video. Coming to Masters in Public Health program course fee at JIPMA, it's very nominal compared to all other institutes in India. It will cost you around 11K. You can finish off your MPH degree with 11K. Coming to how many seats are available for Masters in Public Health program. For unreserved category, we have 8 seats. OBC category, we have 5 seats. SC category, we have 3 seats. ST category, we have 1 seat. Economically weaker section, we have 2 seats. Sponsored category, we have 15 seats. Totally, we have 34 seats. One very important point here to be remembered is, for sponsored category we have 15 seats, right? Suppose only 3 seats were filled from sponsored category, rest 12 seats will be vacant. They will not be pooled into any other category mentioned here. Selection process for Masters in Public Health program is completely based through entrance exam merit list. Students have to appear computer based online entrance exam. He or she will be given 100 MCQs. Each MCQ will carry 4 marks. 100 into 4, total 400 marks entrance exam will be conducted. And remember, JIPMA has negative marking for their entrance exam. There is no interview. Selection of candidates is completely based on entrance exam merit list. Verification of original certificates will be done on the day of admission. coming to qualifying marks for entrance exam. If you belong to unreserved or OBC category, you should secure minimum 50% of marks. If you belong to SC/ST category, you should secure minimum 45% of marks. Remember this point, this is just qualifying marks. Your entrance exam merit list will be taken. Based on the merit, seats will be allotted according to your category wise. So far in this video, we have talked about what is the eligibility criteria, what is the course fee, how many seats are available. In this part of video, we'll be talking about what is the entrance exam syllabus, how should a student prepare for JIPMA Masters in Public Health entrance exam, what are the ideal books to refer. Coming to entrance exam syllabus, you will be having epidemiology, biostats, health economics, national health programs, population sciences, basic knowledge of computer, basic knowledge of English. See, this is your entrance exam syllabus. Coming to what are the ideal books for JIPMER MPH entrance exam. Remember, KPAC textbook is just like a Bible for preventive and social medicine. PSM by Dr. Vivek Jain is the best book in the entrance exam point of view. Chunk of your questions will be from preventive and social medicine. These two books will help you a lot. You should have basic knowledge of English and basic knowledge of computer. I'll drop the links of few books in the description box. Check out that. I hope it will help you out. But these two books are the must. KPAC textbook and PSM by Dr. Vivek Jain. Coming to how to prepare for JIPMER MPH entrance exam. Before going to answer this question, remember three points. First point is that don't focus more on computer knowledge and basic English. They will ask very easy questions. If you see 2021 question paper, all the 100 MCQs are from preventive and social medicine. Not even a single question from basic knowledge of computer or basic English. If you see 2020 question paper of JIPMA MPH program, 98 questions are from preventive and social medicine. Two questions are from, one is from English, one is from computer. So devote large amount of your time for preventive and social medicine. Go through entrance exam syllabus in detail. Be familiar with all the basic concepts of preventive and social medicine. Solve previous year's MCQs. Here I have almost 5-6 videos regarding all the JIPMER previous year's question papers and various MPH entrance exam question bank. Solve all the videos and note down wherever you are doing mistakes. Just revise as many times as possible. Mainly PSM by Vivek Jain will definitely help you out. Coming to stipend for Masters in Public Health program students at JIPMER, there is no stipend for MPH program at JIPMER so far till date 2021. Many students got confused. Do JIPMER offer 10K stipend per month? This stipend is for PG diploma in genetic counseling. It's not for MPH students. JIPMER offers 10,000 stipend to PG diploma in genetic counseling course, not for MPH program. Only three institutes in India offer Masters in Public Health program stipend. One is Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences, Karnataka. One more is NIMHANS, Karnataka. One more is Institute of Public Health, Kalyani, West Bengal. Coming to Masters in Public Health program placements, there is no dedicated placement cell for Masters in Public Health program at JIPMER. Many students often get placed in a very reputed institutions. Professors will guide, but there is no dedicated placement cell in JIPMER. If you haven't practiced previous year's question papers of JIPMER, check out this video. It will definitely help you out. Do subscribe to my channel for all the latest updates.